Up with Japan is Eri Macdonald. And with Eri Macdonald representing Japan at Ni Yamamoto, she was unable to start an ice hockey team back home in Kobe, where she was from, or Tokyo, where she lives, so went into powerlifting, but did play ice hockey, para-ice hockey for Canada across 3 years, and that's where Macdonald comes from. You can join the dots from there. So she's going to start off with an attempt of 48. This is Group B. And we've got 9 going in this. So 48 to get us underway. Eri Macdonald. First major championship in this sport, at least. Large Argentine team here. Could be good for a medal on the way, but here's 50 to get things going, and that looked really, really sweet. 3 out of 3. Well, she sets the standard for the rest to follow. Great work by Karen Rodriguez. And the experience she picked up in Hungary in May would have been a big help. They've a terrific coach as well. A very happy coach. Sophia there, who pretty much looks after the entire team. One of the most regular figures on stage, and what absolute delight. Straight away, first World Championships, first lift at a World Championships for Karen Rodriguez, and she gets it at 50. Krychko, this occasion misses out. So now Krychko denied at 55. Just kind of swung backwards a little bit on the way down, wasn't very smooth, and certainly on the way back. You can see how she got one of the referees her way, and the other two going against. Kelly Cartwright. What is it about Australia? They've already had a representative of The Voice on stage, and now somebody's been in Dancing with the Stars. And obviously, we're dealing with a star here in Kelly Cartwright. Great to be commentating on her again. Gold in the long jump at London 2012, silver in the 100 metres. And the former world champion over those two disciplines. Starting off at 56.
Jump against the strap. Right there.
Start.
Super tight. Punch. Wait. Perfect.
Away she goes at 56. And that is a real vote of confidence. 3 out of 3. Up and running, our new leader for Australia. Kelly Cartwright. And that was a very, very good effort. Right on the button. Kelly Cartwright, the fourth to lift here. Hello from Will Downey, thanks for joining us today. Karen Rodriguez has already lifted and cleared at 50. And misses at 48 for Eri Macdonald of Japan and Hanna Krychko of Belarus at 55. Karen Rodriguez at 50, Kelly Cartwright 56. The two successful lifts so far. Now here comes Manpreet Kaur of India aiming to hit the front on 70. As we get into the full swing of Group B here. First major championship for her as well. Her coach is Vijay Munishwar. So in the early stages of the opening round of Group B here, the lifts are going to go up to 76 in round one. And in Group A, all the way to Rehab Ahmed of Egypt, currently going for 105. Solid and straight, and 2 out of 3, and that's a good lift. So Manpreet Kaur up and running. Nice crowd in for this lunchtime session. 3 events today. If you haven't been with us from the start, the women's 50. Then in 2.5 hours' time, we've the women's 61. And in 4.5 hours' time, the men's 80 getting underway. Just past 1 o'clock here. Women's 61 is at 3:30. And the men's 80 at 5:30 Mexico City time.
Thank you.
And on 7 hours for CET. So very solid lift by Manpreet Kaur at 70. And now for Great Britain. Lifting 74, it's Olivia Broome, the World Junior Silver Medalist from Saturday. Also involved in para swimming and athletics, been competing in those past 12 months in Britain. And put on a good display as well on Saturday in this stadium in the World Juniors. Mm-hmm. 74 for Broom. Well, that'll be a split call, and it's gone against her 2-1. Starting at 74, and with Group A kicking off at 77, a chance to really get in among the top 10 and get higher for Olivia Broom. Good prospect at the age of 16. But not getting the nod this time.
The bar is loaded to 75 kilograms for the first attempt from Morocco.
Halima Lemtakin.
Representante de Marruecos, Halima Lemtakin.
So Halima Lemtakem for Morocco, aiming for 75. First major championship for her as well, 34 years old. And aiming for 75, there's a strong chance that quite a few of the lifters we're seeing here will eventually overtake one of those going in for Group A. It's actually quite congested between the top five of Group B in terms of the weights, and certainly the bottom three in Group A in terms of the weights, first round targets. Halima Lemtakem for 75 for Morocco, her first attempt. And that waggle of the left arm didn't put it back because it's 3 out of 3. And Halima Lemtakem is our new leader for Morocco. Good solid lift, and away she goes. Top of the standings. Well-worn kick for the debutante, but what a good solid lift. And coach just to fly be happy in her as well. She, I think she'd pretty much known that she'd got it spot on, and she was right. So now from Kazakhstan, Gulbanu Abdikulakova. All-time best performance was fourth in the Asian Para Games in 2014 in Incheon. She was seventh at the last World Championships in Dubai 3 years ago, and seventh in Rio last year. Taldi Korgan, Kazakhstan, and again going for 75. Up straight enough, and joins Lemta out of the three. well-supported. To all of the Mexican lifters. These are some of the highest public crowds that I can remember outside of all the lifters, the officials who come to watch. Only a few hundred per session, but getting similar numbers of the public in, which is great, adds to the atmosphere, and you normally get a lot of atmosphere inside a stadium as well. The Capitans play here in the Mexican basketball Super League, fourth right now. And Hernandez will be first if she gets this. She will, you know. She's right to celebrate early. Got it. Got it. Mexican lead. Hernandez, 76. Myra Hernandez up and away, and we have a Mexican leader. We've had Mexican goals already here. Two in the form of Jose de Jesus Castillo in the men's 107, Amelia Perez in the women's 55. Well, she'll compete. There's far heavier to come. So second attempt for Eri Macdonald of Japan, aiming for 48. She's given it, I think, a better stab, but it's still going to be three reds for her. Jeopardy of not registering a mark at all. Back to the drawing board for Eri Macdonald. Not the straightest and brilliant lift, great celebration from Karen Rodriguez in the first round when she cleared 50 for Argentina. Her first major championship on a global basis was fourth in the Pan Ams in Toronto in 2015 and competed in the EGO World Cup in Hungary back in May. They're all based in Mar del Plata. From the capital where she hails. Start. very, very solid. More delight. Her first world championship, and she's burning it up. Cleared 50, cleared 55. If anything, that was an even heartier celebration than last time. Well, she's delivering. She's in sixth place now. And we've got the side-on view with the naked eye, and that couldn't have been any straighter. Just fantastic. Real jubilation. Hanna Krychko now for Belarus. Second attempt at 55, missed it previously. Actually got one out of three. Our officials. See if she can get a bit closer this time. First major championship again. She competed in Hungary this year at the World Cup, and she is from the capital. Go for 55.
Start. Jim. Run.
Exactly the same again. 2-1 against. You could see on the head-on shot that left hand was considerably higher, and noticeably higher anyway, than the right. So. Else to try and fix. Well, a couple of attempts from the Belarusian at 55. She's missed out on both. Gold in London, silver in the 100, and prior to that in 2011 she'd won both those titles, Christchurch in the World Championships. Fabulous athlete, was in the Australian edition of Dancing with the Stars. Sorry if you're watching this on demand, we've already said all this, but live viewers haven't had the full CV, although she's well known enough not to need it explained. Big name in para sport, in Australia. Great lifter, 56 last time. And 59, a little bit more of a struggle.
No lift.
4. Run. Tidied it up.
Good.
They were all happy with it.
Good lift.
Good lift and all happy.
Loaders, please load the bar to 74 kilograms. Red high.
Puts 13. Her into fourth place. Solid attempt at 74. As I say, not much difference really between that and the previous effort. Sufficiently cleaner to go into fourth spot.
Thank you. The bar is loaded to 74 kilograms for a second attempt from India.
Kaur Manpreet.
Representante de India, Kaur Manpreet.
So Manpreet Kaur of India got 70, was a really good lift last time, and this would put her above Olivia Broome in terms of the body weight, going again for 74. Good smooth lift for the major championship debutante earlier. And aiming for an extra 4 on the bar here, and this would put her into fourth place. An extra kilo. Start. 78, 3 added on.
Rock.
Quite stalled on the way up, so it's not going to go away this time. And it's a 0 out of 3. It didn't look like it. So a couple of attempts at 79 to follow, but at the Kalakova, it's not quite there at 78. Extra effort needed, the uplift, and it just began to stray a bit there.
Myra.
So back again to the home favorite, Myra Hernandez from Mexico, lifted 76 in the previous round, and this to take the lead in 79. This to retain the lead in 79. The calls for Morocco, here comes Salima Lemtekem, who cleared 75 in the opening round and going to lift 79 now. I think they were just a bit disappointed a few moments ago, but depending what Hernandez aims to go for in round three, can get quite advanced. She and Kalakova and Kaur missing out in the mid to high 70s. Lemtekem going now at 79. So far, nobody's going to go above 80 in round three, but that'll change if she gets this. Lemtekem, 79. That's strayed quite a bit, so that's certainly not going to be given. Maybe it's close to the limit of what's liftable by her. Did get it raised, but it's strayed considerably. Round two done. We only had two successful lifts in that second round, and only two of the nine yet to register a mark. And we're going to see one of those right now to get round three up and running. For Japan, Eri Macdonald, who missed attempts at 48. Following somewhat of a plan here as she's going for 51. Macdonald, aiming for 51. Taking her time under the bar on each occasion. She's got her set routine. Just one important thing to change, is to get some white lights going.
Oh.
Down to 25 seconds. She's given that a good stab, but it's again three out of the three giving it the thumbs down. So no mark, I'm afraid, for Eri Macdonald here in the first major championship. And Japan sending quite a decent sized team here. It's despite the fact a few nations did pull out in the run-up to this, obviously the championships suspended for a couple of months due to the earthquake that hit here in the tragedy in September. Plans had to be shifted. Despite that, still the record number of countries and competitors. Japan, it feels like they've got somebody in every event.
Hanna Krychko.
Anna Krychko of Belarus going again for 55 for the third time. And like Eri Macdonald, no joy with her first two lifts. So four more to go. Just drifted back and drifted back. Coach sort of knew what was coming. Next up for Great Britain, and having cleared 74, needed two attempts to do it. Here comes the final stab, and going for 77. Well, capable of this much at the age of 16, there's a good career and a very, very long one coming, you would think. About got there, I think, and did. Two out of three. Right at the top, it was beginning to drift, but she had done enough. That was fabulous. So, it's been good and bad for Gulbina. Diklakova so far for Kazakhstan. Got 75, missed out, and 78. Fourth in the Asian Para Games last time out in Incheon. Any further west and you drift into European sport in Azerbaijan. They hosted the European Games 2 years ago where there's no para element yet. Someone will have to pick up the phone. But not him. I wouldn't rely on him. Delikova at 78 and wavered a bit, but again she'll be okay. Gets it at 78 and into the lead for Kazakhstan, Dikhalikova. That was a good lift as well at 78, two out of the three away. At the end, little bounce and bang on, two out of the three. Middle judge, said referee, Eliane Uraku of Greece, side referee, Stella Herrick, USA, Joyce Sheard, Great Britain. Now guess where our next lift is from? Mera Hernandez of Mexico, second stab at 79. What she missed out on last time, and it was three reds. Hope they're not here for the day. She's the only Mexican competitor who's due all day in the three events. Also hope they're not going home immediately after this. Helped with the atmosphere today. Mera Hernandez then, 79. for Mexico.
Stop.
So 79. She gave that her all. Didn't get the lift though. Sort of, it was interesting reaction from her. Interesting reaction from them as well. But interesting from her, just she lifted it up because she obviously thought it was a bit tentative. And she was right. But lifted 76, she's third. To Kim for 80. She struggled with 79, but seemed to do a little bit better there. It's not going to help her, mind you, because it's not out of three, but I thought that was a better lift than a previous one. So she finishes on 75 for Morocco. A brilliant first round lift of 75, but she's missed out on two. Fourth place, leaving Group B. Hernandez for Mexico on 76. Broom of Great Britain, 77. And Abdikalakova of Kazakhstan, 78. And this women's 50 kg. Not a million miles away. In terms of the scoring, she was. But for her, no success with the last two lifts, did very well with the opener. So we go into Group A now, and there's 10 going in this. Real prime quality. Reigning world and Paralympic champions, Asian game champion, various European world and Paralympic medalists too. And we kick off again with Kazakhstan and Kabira Askarova. Seventh in the 2012 Paralympic Games in London from Kizzy Lorda. First world championship, though she's been on the scene a few years. Oh dear. Well, you know what? Looks like she's gone in too heavy. If that's happening with her first round attempt, she's in bother for the competition. Unless she was caught unawares this one and only time. Anyway, Kabira Askarova. Doesn't get that, misses out at 77. And right from the off, if it happens in the third round, you can kind of think, well, they've gone up and up and they've reached their natural level, but if it happened in the first round, it'd be a bit unfortunate. They've been doing kiss cam here, if you've been wondering.
Wiunawis, Hernandez.
So next for Venezuela, Wiunawis Hernandez going for 80. A fourth world championship. Best result came in the very first one back in 2002 in Kuala Lumpur. We're all back there for the Asian Paras next year. Obviously won't affect her, but she finished fifth there in the first world championship. She's had fifth, sixth and seventh placed finishes. Wasn't in the last Worlds in Dubai, and in her only Paralympic Games in Beijing, didn't register a mark. It's her first major championship in 7 years. She was unwell for a while. Missed a championship or two as a result. But back on the scene. Latin American World Championship. And Hernandez for Venezuela going for 80. Welcome back. 3 out of 3. Wiunawis Hernandez and into the lead. And that was just smashing. Well, that was just terrific. Lot to be appreciative of there. Nice and clean. Good line. Straight up. Level bar. Smooth lift, all the elements there. Sakina Khatun of India now going for 87. Commonwealth Games bronze medalist in Glasgow 3 years ago and aiming for Gold Coast next year. Based in Bangalore now, was fourth in the Asian Para Games in Incheon in 2014. Three major championships she had in the 1 year, and unfortunately after those really good finishes, or before those really good finishes, later on in the year, at the start of the year in Dubai around April, when the World Championships were on, didn't register a mark. So starting with 87 here, and maybe deliberately aiming a little bit low. Subsequently, you could say that she'd learned from that World Championship experience and having those high finishes at the Commonwealths and the Asian Games. So 87, Sakina Khatun, and that is all three against. Hard lines that time. Coming out at 87. All adds up. Is that weight to something quite considerable?
Rayisa
Toporkova for Ukraine, going for 90 kg here. The reigning world champion from Dubai in 3 years ago, but no mark in Rio at the Paralympic Games. Her best Paralympics, fourth in Beijing in 08. And in the last two European championships, a silver and a bronze. Four major championship medals. coach there had some great words, some helpful words for after the Paralympic Games when there was a bit of despair. Had a bad day. To be honest, that was bad. A new lead race of Toporkova of Ukraine. Well, again, a strong Ukrainian squad. Toporkova, top of the world at the moment. Excellent lift. Couldn't be faulted. Two from Ukraine in the for Chen Meijiao, major championship from Wyoming. Here, she's the lightest in of those in the group by almost 2 kilos. Head to heads, she has the advantage. So to be good for them. That was just super from Chen. And hitting the front at 90. String of World Championship debutants for China. Not even with Rio to their name. But that was clean as 93 from Chen Meijiao. Must doing exactly the same as me. Here comes the Loida's first attempt in the round. Coach support goes in 11 and 13 50 Paralympics, fourth last world championship, won the Egger World Cup title in 3A. Ada, there is global base. The 08 Paralympics, 7th in the 2010 World. The last world champion, 5th in Rio last year. Generally, would have a chance of Lloyd Zabala. Look at an athlete who's popularity in her country. She's it.
Two out of three, and you lead as well. It's a
to one, it was, that's fine. And into she's got a great one, and into the follow through and pushed up well in three out of three, and she's our new leader for Vietnam, Dang Thi Linh Phuong. Good, powerful effort. No problem at all for the Vietnamese lifter. 5 finish for Stina. Yesterday. Narrowly out of the medals this time. Besra Duman of Turkey into the top three attempts of the opening round, and she's going for the 100. New world junior champion from Saturday, and who finished fourth in the Europeans in Ege 2 years ago from Konya in Turkey. Good win to claim the gold ahead of Olivia Broom. Start of the week here in Mexico City. Besra. It's a split call, but it's a good one her way. 2-1. And she is now in the lead. Another excellent lift. It was a junior world record for her on Saturday of 105, so keep your eyes out for that. Cracking lift though for 100.
From
Lidiia Soloviova.
Representante de Ucrania, Lidiia Soloviova.
So for Ukraine, Lidiia Soloviova. 103 is her target. 39-year-old reigning Paralympic Games champion. Three Paralympic golds in Athens, Beijing and Rio. And on a silver for Sydney, a bronze in London. World champion from 2006. One of four world championship medals she's claimed. The other three are silvers. And she's the reigning European champion as well from Dnipro in Ukraine. Lidiia Soloviova. Three to kick off. And that'll do it. Took a while for the third official to give a call, but she got two early whites, 2-1 in her favour. And she is our new leader, 103. Reigning European and Paralympic champion. Silver in the Ukraine 1-2 behind Rayisa Toporkova in Dubai in 2014. It's Gabby who does the announcements in Spanish. Normally works here at the basketball league, the Capitans. And this is a very, very good chap keeping us on air. Despite our best efforts to knock it off. So Rehab Ahmed of Egypt going for 105. For Egypt. The Paralympic silver medalist behind Lidiia Soloviova in Rio last year. And 105 per target. Perennially successful at major championships. Rehab Ahmed going for the highest target in round 105. Looks nailed on, into the lead, perfect set of marks at 105 for Rehab Ahmed for Egypt. And in front, it's been a terrific opening round in Group A, only two misses out of 10, and the top seven weights all successful. Ahmed 105, Soloviova 103, good and clean. Well, we are dealing with quality here. Duman 100. And to think she was a little bit worried looking across. No need to be. Gentlemen, all our music. So Kabira Askarova of Kazakhstan goes again for 77. get her on the board, it would put her into ninth position. Just below her teammate, Abdi Kalakova, who got 78 in the final round. The last 12 lifts, 10 have been successful. Askarova, one of those to miss out. She can rectify that with another stab at 77 here. Got it a bit higher this time, but definitely looks as if she's gone in too high. Two misses at 77, and no marks so far for Kabira Askarova. Just that bit too much, but she got it raised. So prospects that maybe to get a clean lift next time around. From
Venezuela. Wiunawis Hernandez.
Representante de Venezuela, Wiunawis Hernandez.
Cracking lift of 80 last time around for Wiunawis Hernandez of Venezuela. That was 80. This is 85 being attempted now. Hernandez adding five on. It won't improve her placing, but obviously a few to be added on. So still going to be eighth after this, but 85 would give her a good foundation for more in the last round if she were to get it. She won't though. 2-1 against. Again, it just began to drift. The higher up it went. Hernandez denied at 85. So, bit of a decision to come for the final round, whether to go up a little bit, try and overtake Toporkova. Place above her, but also 10 kilograms above. The next to go, Sakina, Ikhatun of India. Second attempt at 87, which he missed out last time. The Commonwealth Games bronze medalist. Busy next year. Asian Championships are on in Japan. The Asian Para Games in Kuala Lumpur and the Commonwealth Games, Gold Coast, Eastern Australia. Still loads of time. Second attempt at 87 for Ikhatun. Won't get it though. And in jeopardy of being wiped out. Level. full of interested fellow competitors. Rayisa Toporkova of Ukraine coming now, having cleared 90 in the first round, going for 94 now. Currently in seventh place, but if she gets this, she jumps to fifth. Still be a few kilos away from the medals. Defending world champion.
Come on,
struggle to raise it, and three against. Right from when the spotters released it, she appeared to be in a bit of bother there. She is a past master at this level. Missing 94 though. Still seventh, having cleared 90 in the opening round. At the slowest point. It was a bit lopsided towards her left hand side. Successful lifts yet in this second round.
Thank you. The bar is loaded to 99 kilograms for second attempt from Spain.
Loida, Zabala.
Representante de España, Loida, Zabala.
Loida, Zabala for Spain. Got 94 last time. This for 99 to go fourth and within a kilogram of the medals. Crowds roused again. What a popular athlete. Well, if she gets this, it's game on. Besra Duman in the bronze medal position on 100. Duman with the lighter body weight, so Zabala going for 100 here would still not get into the medals. A prime contender. Misses out at 99, Loida Zabala. Prospect of coming back for that in the next round. Well, she stays in fifth place. A bit more work to do. But remember, she comes back at 99. Only would have been for fourth place in round two. Pity.
She's
Well, now in sixth place, Chen Meijiao for China. Big ambitions here. She's sixth, adding seven to the bar, and this to go into the bronze medal position. Road to Tokyo 2020 with a largely new team. For 100 for the bronze medal position. That is a real struggle on the way up, and it's none out of three. Got it raised in the end, lots of effort. As the standard gone too high for some of our prime contenders. Zabala and Chen knocking on the door of 100, but unable to get there. No successful lifts in this second round yet by anybody. And began to hit the wall there. Probably ceiling would be more accurate. Well, the stakes rising along with the weight. Dang Thi Linh Phuong of Vietnam lying in fourth place on 98, and this to go into the silver medal position. The Paralympic bronze medalist and the Southeast Asian champion and the Asian Games silver medalist. Didn't dally, was it clean? She's got there, 2-1. And that final nod, it was one all in the voting for quite a bit there, and then the final one swaying her way. And she goes into the silver medal position ahead of Lidiia. Soloviova, very good lift. Nothing stopping her. That was a thumping lift. Throws her into the Besra medals. Next for Turkey, Besra Duman. now lying out of the medals in fourth place, but this to go into the gold medal position. Besra Duman at 106. And this for a new junior world record as well. She's the junior world champion, and she's in the gold medal position here. Besra Duman with a junior world record, and she hits the front. How about junior and senior gold in the same week? It's possible now. It was 3 out of 3 as well. Two more lifts to come in this second round, but what a follow through, a terrific lift by the 17-year-old, and that's a new junior world record. She's actually a month away from her 17th birthday, and she's leading in the World Championship final with a new junior world record. Next to come, trying to regain top spot. She was there towards the end of the first round and attempted 107 for Lidiia Soloviova of Ukraine. The reigning Paralympic champion from Rio and the 2006 world champion. Three world silvers also. And in with a big shout again, but she's fallen to fourth for the moment. To struggle. Soloviova missing out. Ah, shake of the head. Lee when it was about 80%, 90% raised. Ahmed of Egypt leading at the end of the opening round. She's now fallen to second place. Relegated by Besra Duman of Turkey with that junior world record of 106. Ahmed going for 108 to regain the lead. Ahead 106. Soloviova missing out at 107. Currently out of the medals. Rehab Ahmed in second place. Paralympic silver medalist has now overtaken the Paralympic champion. To go into the gold medal position. Well, for 108, that looks really good. It's better than that, it's brilliant. Ahmed back in the gold medal position, leading, going into the final round with 108. That's a terrific lift. Well, that really hots things up. Superb lift. Ahmed at 108. And again, hope more than expectation that the right result would come up for her. She need not have worried. Final round then. Kabira Askarova of Kazakhstan coming in again at 77. Just to bring you up to speed with the third round attempts then. And Chen and Zabala are going to stay at their mark, so not in medal contention. Soloviova, who's currently in fourth place, will be attempting a lift for a silver medal. Dang, who is third, will be looking to leap into second as well, but Besra Duman will be attempting to overtake Ahmed to go for gold. Go for another junior world record of 110. That's the excitement that's awaiting us. Askarova, final attempt, first of all, of 77. Askarova, 77. I think that's her best effort of the lot, but again, she won't be given it. But that was the cleanest lift of the lot. She had massive problems, worrying problems with her first attempt at 77. They'd obviously thought it was something she'd have been capable of, and today, sadly not. But that was her best attempt. So Sakina Khatun of India, similar position, trying to avoid a similar fate, two misses at 87. Here's her third and final attempt at it. And if she gets it, she would finish in eighth place. But with Wiunawis Hernandez still to come, so it would be at worst ninth if she clears this. And if she doesn't clear this, well, not on the board. The 2018 diary is going to be very, very full with the Asians, the Commonwealths. Championships last on 3 years ago. That was the year she had three major championships in the one season. So 87. Again, that probably looked her best of the lot. It's going to be a split call this time, but it's 2-1 against. Well, it was three red lights for the previous two attempts. Each of the previous two, that one was almost looking as if she was going to go away. But the final vote, obviously, none of the referees know how the others are judging it until the lights go up. Yeah, but it was 1-1 for a good chunk of that, and then the deciding judge going against. She misses out 1-2, so again, no mark for her. So that means, at worst, it was Hernandez who finishes in eighth place, and because she's going for something which won't see her leap any further, she finishes in eighth. Good performance for her. going for 88.
Wiunawis, Hernandez.
Winner was Hernandez of Venezuela. Cleared 80, missed 85, but she's sticking to her plan, going for 88 here. Trying to remember with Sakina Katun, because she'd had three major championships in 2014, what her third one was going to be next year, but the world's now rotating every 2 years and odd numbered years. So 2019 it is Almaty in Kazakhstan, 2021 it is Eger in Hungary. Again, good venue, nice little city that, in north of Hungary. And next year the continental championships, Europeans in France near Calais, Algiers and Algeria for the Africans, Japan for the Asians, and Cali and Cartagena in Colombia for the Americas, which is where we'll be seeing. Winner is Hernandez. Solid stab at 88, but no avail.
No lift.
No lift. It was going to be eighth anyway. Successful with her first attempt and no more. That was 80. Finishes there. Up in eighth. Hernandez eighth, and that means that Lina Abdikaldakova of Kazakhstan ends in ninth place, and Olivia Broom of Great Britain in 10th at the age of 16. Took a while, and that was the problem. Raised standards along with the raised weights in final round, no successes yet. Rayisa Toporkova of Ukraine. And going again at 94, having missed out on this in the previous round. Having the final spray of chalk going. The outgoing world champion. Well, this to leap two spots. Lifted 90 in the first round, missed 94 in round two. This to overtake Chen on 93. And Zabala on 94. Toporkova to get into the top five with a lift of 94. Looked a lot better. She'll get clean marks across the board. Three out of three. She leaps to fifth place.
Loaders, please load the bar to 99 kilograms.
Well, we won't have two Ukrainian medalists. And the current positions, they're in fourth and fifth. That's what she wanted to do last time. If she had done so, it still would have been a massive ask for her, really, today, to have gone above 100, but that was a nice lift of 94. So six to go.
Loida, Zabala.
Well, the next two not going for medals. It's really a battle for fifth. Toporkova's leading it. Zabala and Chen still have a few words to say. Zabala missed out 99 last time. What about now? Thank you. victory in Hungary this year in the World Cup. World Championships currently seeing her lying in sixth place. This the lift for fifth. Zabala for Spain. It's getting there, it's getting there.
No lift.
2-1 against, and that last decision took a long, long time. It was 1-1 for an eternity. She's put an immense amount into it, and maybe slightly too much. You can't help be a fan. Seriously couldn't have put any more into that, really couldn't. Wanted that lift to 99 to get up into fifth spot. And she stays in sixth for now. I think she might have just strained herself too. But whether there's a little bit of internal anguish more than anything else, well, the docs will have a look. She left everything, absolutely, purely everything on that bench. She couldn't have come any closer. 2-1 against, and as I say, that last decision to make it 2-1. There was lots of pondering and thought and consideration. Talk about it being marginal. Well, sixth place for Loida Zabala. So Toporkova and Zabala finishing on 94. Chen Meijiao with 93 in the opening round. Missed out on 100 last time, going for 100 here. The medals begin at 104. And this to go fifth. Toporkova with that 94 puts her in fifth place above Zabala's 94. Slightly lighter body weight of half a kilogram. So Toporkova with the nod over Zabala in that way, but Chen can leap over them both from seventh to fifth with this, and it's worth 100. Slowly does it. Unsuccessfully does it though. No lift. None out of three. So she finishes on 93, and it is seventh place for Chen. And Toporkova with that final round lift finishes in fifth place. Loida Zabala in sixth for Spain. And Chen Meijiao, quite a solid debut world championship for the Chinese from Maoming. Went up by degrees. So seventh in the end, 93, her limit. Well, from here it gets really interesting. Lidiia Soloviova is in fourth place at the moment with 103. She's going to attempt a silver medal lift, as is Dang. who's currently in third, and the athlete in second, Besra Duman, by the time she reaches the stage, could be in fourth place. She's going for gold, obviously, because she's in second right now. Lidiia Soloviova in fourth place for Ukraine, 103. The reigning Paralympic champion, gunning for silver here. She's won silver in three of the last four World Championships, and the World Championship where she didn't win silver, she won it outright. The reigning European champion, the reigning Paralympic champion, and this to go into the silver medal position. For Soloviova, missed that 107 last time, but if she gets this, it's heading for second place. It's going to be a split call, and it's gone against. Out of the medals, close to a silver. Again, she was hanging on at one all for a long time there. She will finish fourth, the Paralympic and European champion. She'll keep those titles. So it's the first World Championship out of five in which she hasn't won a medal. But she can still console herself with those two great titles. So, Soloviova in fourth. Dang of Vietnam. Two successes so far at 98 and at 104. Now going for 107, put her into the silver medal position. Like the shoes. For Nat, and this an attempt at a silver. Dang at 107. Didn't waste a lot of time in doing it. Good lift up to the silver medal position. 107 for Dang of Vietnam. She won the Southeast Asian title again in September in Malaysia. She's a multi-gold medalist there, and at the moment up to silver here. 2-1, she was actually hanging on that decisive vote for quite a while, but it came through. Two left to lift.
Thank you. The bar is loaded to 112 kilograms for third attempt from Turkey.
Besra Duman.
2 to go. Now in the bronze medal position for Turkey. Besra Duman. That lift of 106 in round two, a new junior world record. That's the 13th junior world record this week. It's the third time this week that she's broken that world record. The junior world champion. And if she gets this, she's on the brink of becoming the senior world champion. What a remarkable double. She needs the lift of her life. At 112. And it's not to be. It's bronze for Besra Duman. Junior gold, senior bronze. She's 16 years old. She's going to be a massive name in the future. She's a massive name now. That's bronze for Turkey for Besra Duman, and she was really close to that. A little higher, that would have been it. Silver for Dang of Vietnam. That is the best global result of her career. And it's gold for Egypt, for Rehab Ahmed, the Paralympic silver medalist, is a global champion for the first time in her career. So here's our new world champion, Rehab Ahmed, clearing 108. And with Duman going for 112, Ahmed's 113 was an obvious tactic to defend the gold medal position. Egypt's second gold of these championships, and they won two golds in the Junior Worlds on Saturday. So Ahmed going for 113, the new world champion. Ahmed then, the new world champion. Can she round off with something spectacular? You know what? She's done it. She's done it. Of course she's done it. New world champion for Egypt, Rehab Ahmed. She's cleared 113. Sensational. Silver at the Paralympic Games, but this is dream stuff. And a Paralympic silver is good enough. But she is a world champion and loving it. Two golds for Egypt now in Mexico City in the seniors, four overall, on the mark, and concerned all the time. She doesn't have to be. Not when she's that good. That was really absorbing. Top class stuff again. It was silver for Dang Ti Lin Phuong, the multi-Southeast Asian champion. World silver for Vietnam and bronze for the 16-year-old from Turkey. And junior world champion, Besra Duman. Kudos as well to Soloviova in fourth for Ukraine, a compatriot, Toporkova, who finished fifth. Zabala, Chen, sixth and seventh, both Giants too. That was terrific stuff, and well done, Rehab Ahmed. Karen Rodriguez was celebrating as if she'd won gold. Keep your eyes on her in years to come. 14th, Olivia Broom in 10th. 16 years old, the second placer in the Junior Championships on Saturday. Kelly Cartwright, after being a world and Paralympic champion in athletics, hope she sticks with this for a long time, because we could see her on page one in years to come.